Okay, with a quorum being present, I call this meeting of the Recreation and Parks Advisory Committee to order. Everybody was emailed a copy of the agenda last week. Anybody have any changes to that? No?
Motion to approve the agenda.
All right, second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, motion carries. All right, we also had a copy of the minutes from last month emailed to us at the same time. Anybody have any changes to the minutes? If not, looking for a motion?
I'll move.
Second.
All right, all in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? All right, motion carries. And with that, gets us to the interim director's report. You guys gonna arm wrestle a little bit?
Me and Michael are still gonna tag team on that. I'll go ahead and get us started. Just an update, I wanted to let you know that since we last had our meeting, we had the Jamboree on May 3rd. I wanted to let you know it went well. We had a beautiful day for it, so it brought out folks in droves, so we had a real nice turnout. But if you have any suggestions, I know we saw Homer there, but if any of you came out or have any suggestions or feedback, we are already working on next year's and, you know, finding ways to make it even better, so.
I was out of town. How did the car show thing go?
It went well. There was some cars that didn't come out, but it was actually a pretty popular hit, and lots of people enjoyed the new, that element to the event from what we've heard. There were some pretty neat cars out there, so everything from a Volkswagen van to Camaros to a lawnmower. What was the lawnmower's name? Lightning something or another? I don't know, but it was a souped up lawnmower, so yeah, it was interesting.
Excellent.
But it went well. Other than that, we wanted to let you know that tomorrow night there are two vacancies on the board, and council has recommendations, so tomorrow night is when they'll be appointed. So hopefully at the next meeting we'll have some new members, so stay tuned for that. Other than that, on the recreation side of the house, we have a day camp starting. Kids get out of school less than a month from now, so we will have all of our summer programs starting here real soon, so the kids will be out all day, and we will have them with all of our day camps, and then we'll be back into after school programs and everything else. So we're busy on the recreation side of the house, and then I think Michael has some updates on the project. We'll just jump on in.
Yeah, and just from the park side, you know, baseball's in full swing for us, so we're doing a lot of ball fields and obviously mowing grass. Mm-hmm. Just so you're all aware, as you know, I think our horticulturalist Kate Perkins is leaving us June 20th. We are conducting interviews currently to fill that position. Feel good about that. So hopefully within the next month we'll have a new staff member. Obviously just be aware of that. Project updates from our end. Phillips Park. We've talked about Phillips Park with you, and if you'll look on the TV, I think we have a map here. And this is just a draft of basically a site plan that we have looked at for the park. So if you look down here, and I'll try, and I've never done this, so bear with me, you'll see that this is Highway 17, so you would enter the park from here. You see the launch is right here, which is kind of where the existing playground and shelter are at today, but on the water. And then as you go through the park, you see we've got a playground, and then the shelter with restrooms, and then the stage for the amphitheater, which is right there. And then you see we also have some parking, and we're trying to incorporate the road here that leads out to Queens.
Mm-hmm.
So currently, you know, as the park sits today, it's kind of disjointed. You can all, you know, you either enter from one end and you have to go out that way. This will add some continuity through the park for you to be able to go in one area and come out the other. And we just wanted to show that to you just as a nothing else to keep you in the loop. This is just some ideas we've been throwing around. It seems to fit well with the land, and our engineers are going to do some borings actually at the end of this week to check the site. And as we get those reports back, we'll move forward with that park as time goes by. Any questions about that?
Has there been any, I'm sorry, Chairman, if there's been any feedback from the residents that live in that area?
We haven't taken this to the residents yet because we actually just got this Friday.
Today at 3.
Actually, I'm sorry, today at 3.
Yes.
We obviously wanted to have something to show them. We're also want to wait until the borings are done because that may lead us to reposition some of these things. So we wanted to give them kind of an accurate picture of what they would see before we took it to them. So I hope that answered your question.
Yes,
Michael, has anybody checked the water depth there where that launching pad is? Because it gets awfully shallow there sometimes.
Yes. Yeah, and they actually are checking that. And as far as I know to this date, the thought is that that's going to be sufficient enough for the kayaks to launch from that area.
Probably the best place was parking is maybe 100 feet away. Any other place, they'd be portaging their canoe kayak several hundred feet.
Right. Moving on from Phillips, if there's no more questions, we are working on Amiette. Some of you can see, who have been by there, have seen the ball field. We have about 2 months left of work out there. You will see in the next week ball field lights being delivered, being assembled, and then hopefully in the next 30 days being actually installed. If you've not ridden by there and you're familiar with baseball or softball or anything like that, you can start to see what looks like the layout of a ball field. Now, you're going to have to look at it to see that, but definitely over the next 30 days, I think you're going to see the shape of a ball field start taking place where just about anybody that rides by can see that. So that's pretty much where we're at with Jack Amiette. Unless you have
Jack Amiette, no, that's about it. I will mention too that down at LP Welling, well, Kerr Street ball field, we are, because of these ball fields moving, we are putting a fence down at that park. So we'll be using that one to kind of transition over from the one over here at Phillips Park. So we'll have a fence down at Kerr Street starting in June. So everything's moving along, dominoes kind of falling in place.
One other project, just to keep you in the loop on, is Northeast Creek, the lagoons. Engineering has hired somebody to do the final grading for closing what we call the existing lagoons. That doesn't mean they're ready for us to build on them or anything. It just meets the requirements from the state for closing the lagoons. He's been out there working, I know, last week. It may already be done, but I'm not sure. But that's in the process. So, you know, officially the lagoons, by the next time we meet, will probably be closed. And that's a good step in the next direction for us. So just, you know, again, keeping you in the loop, be aware of that. And I think that's our report.
Okay. So that gets you down to basically budget meetings?
Well, the budget meetings are ongoing. I know there's a workshop tomorrow night. Council has met with management, and you know, we'll just have to see as things go forward what happens. But there is a workshop tomorrow night, and we'll just have to stay tuned.
Is there going to be anything exciting?
Always I do exciting. Not know that. I think they're always exciting.
Always. All right. It gets us down to the Planning Advisory Board Liaison Report. Mr. Spring is not here, but here's his report. Let's see, Dunkin' Donuts. There's possible 2 new locations in Jacksonville. Excellent. All right, so one would be a new construction close to Lowe's Food Site on Gum Branch Road, and the other would be redevelopment of a site near New River Air Station entrance. All the guys at New River would be excited about that. All right, and then Port City, Java. All right, hey, that's good news. All right, it's going to be at 102 Marine Boulevard. So it's an alteration uplift permit to convert the former Taco Bell, which then became the All-American Barbecue and Smokehouse. Oh, so that's going to be right downtown.
Yeah.
Oh, all you,
safety building.
All you City Hall people should be really happy about that. All right, and then an old Chicago pizza and tap room at 4157 Western. There's a plan review for an interior uplift to a tenant space with a proposed shell building that's under construction. Okay, that's everything from that. All right. All right. I'm happy about the Port City Java. Excellent. Okay, that finishes off that. gets us to council liaison report. Mr. Willingham.
Good evening, everyone. The I think the budget items from the Recreation Department have been well received so far. We're in the process of hashing that out, and it's anticipated that on the 3rd of June, we will pass a budget. But we've had a good presentation from Recreation based on the questions and concerns. I think, again, it's been well received. Council may be sending to this board the Less Move program that's sponsored by the National League of Cities. It's an effort to get our communities moving and active. And we have been contacted by the National League, and it hasn't been anything that's been on the agenda and presented to council, but I anticipate that they will be considering that and considering whether to get input from this board on the Less Move program. And we passed, I think, approval or a recommendation for council regarding the outdoor fitness equipment, the resistance equipment. That's, I think council is going to take another look at that. And that's the exercise equipment that goes outside. It's the equivalent of weightlifting machines, but it uses your body weight and resistance. And it's very durable. It's very popular around the country. And it gives our community who might not be interested in going to fitness centers or might not want to put out the money for fitness centers. It gives them an opportunity to be out in the parks and to get that kind of exercise also. So we may be taking another look at that. That's about it.
Anything else?
Nope.
Okay. Gets us down to member comments of park reports. Mr. Ross.
Is there a Sunday afternoon at Wooten Park, about 8 or 9 playing basketball, a couple little kids, everybody's having a good time. Park looks great, still looks brand new. Great job, no problems.
Lori.
Richard Ray in the comments, just like Bill said, Wooten looked great. Flowers have kind of fallen off everything, but it still looks nice and green and pretty. If I can just add on Jack Emmett, there's two basketballs that need nets. The nets have come across. Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Two of the four.
Thank you.
Homer's not here, but he did give us a park report. So he said Branchwood, no problems. But there was nobody there the three times he visited. Sherwood Park, nice and quiet, clean, no problems. But some activity, there were people using it as a dog park, which is good. Phillips Park, moderate usage of the picnic area and the ball fields with some of the, and some of the playground is very clean. So thanks, Homer, if you're listening. don't have anything on Northwoods, Northeast Creek. I went there today. The lagoons, there's a, the, whoever's doing the last part of it there, there's a tractor with a big disc thing, and he's broke up all the clods, and there's some other thing with, I don't know what it is. But anyway, so those pieces of equipment are out there and they're doing the bit. They were working on the road. They had a front end, they had a backhoe, they had a dump truck, they had a compactor making lots of dust and noise. So our tax dollars will work out there today.
Good.
There were people playing disc golf. The disc golf course looked great. The baseball fields were immaculate. There were people over the playground. If we could just get it, the playground looking as nice as the ball fields, that would be terrific.
We're working on that.
I mean, $100 of paint. That's about all you need. That and get somebody to rake the sand. So have those baseball field guys go over there after they get done and do the same stuff they do to the baseball field to the playground. Right. Warren.
Okay. Woodlands Park looked fine. Works the JAS, they takes care of the fields and all of that. The trail looks fine. I was only been up to the bridge, so that's all I can speak to. From Warlick, which is just the first block after the middle school, down to the bridge, they've got these surveyor flags. Is that, does anybody know if that's related to anything specific?
I'm not sure what that's for. I'm sure it's something to do with either sewer or streets.
Okay.
That would be my guess.
And once again, the crossing there at Hargett Street is very nice. I mean, now they lined it. You've got that one center turn lane, you've got two lanes going each way, and then they've got the 4-foot bike, I think it's about a 4-foot bike lane. Very nice. In addition to that, where you cross there at Hargett, they've got that marked as well with the pedestrian crossing. In addition to that, they have widened where you can actually cross. Used to, it was a bit narrow, but now it's very nice through there, so that all looks well. Sturgeon City looks fine. Planted quite a few new trees down there. Is that what this Ms. Perkins is responsible for?
Yes.
Yeah, there were several. I mean, but it looked good. A couple guys out there fishing, so I don't know if they were catching anything, but they were throwing the rod out. That's all I have, Steve.
Okay. Jim?
I checked Brook Valley Sunday morning, probably too early because nobody was there. It looked good, though, as it always does. The only thing I noticed, there's a whale ride, the best way to describe it, at this, on Springs, and it's full of sand again, and you'd expect that because it's in a sand lot, it'll cushion the fall if somebody should fall off of there. Well, I guess the kids or who rides it play games that just fill the whale up with sand. People are using the trash cans there, as I checked, and there's no trash on the ground, but all the trash cans were about half full. I know you've got somebody that comes around later on Sunday and empties all those.
Correct.
So I'm glad to see the trash cans are being used. Makes my job a little easier. That's all I've got.
All right. Samantha?
Well, somebody looks good. I was by there on Saturday. It was nice and clean. There was a few people accessing the park, children on the playground equipment. It was pretty clean.
Ashley?
I just want to give kind of kudos to the park group. Woodlands was well received during the Kepner Cup. It was gorgeous out there, and NCYSA staff loved it. Didn't hear any complaints from the families that were there. In fact, they were talking about how nice and neat and well tended to the whole entire area was. So your staff does a great job. I know JASTA takes care of the fields, but there were more than enough kids hanging on to the playground equipment and the rest of it. So thank you guys so much for making that a great spot for us to hold that tournament, or at least a piece of it. The only other thing I have is we are working towards our strategic plan. So we have just cut off the survey portion. It's been a little interesting. There are some comments I think that city and county Parks and Rec would be interested in. And we'll kind of pass those along as we go through everything. But there is a huge outpouring of us using and utilizing the water even more. So we're going to be researching and figuring out what we can do to help increase the traffic of sports tourism on the water. But that'll probably be something that comes to you guys as well, as just recommendation and thoughts of different things that we can do. I'm familiar with water skiing on lakes and deep sea fishing. So when it comes to our rivers, I'm like, all right, so what do we do? So I've been doing some research already, but again, just getting a little bit of input from you guys on what your thoughts are, since you may travel them a lot more often than I do. So that's all I have.
Dragon boat races?
We tried that.
You did?
And Paddle Fest actually had it too in Swansboro at Hammocks Beach.
Fishing tournament.
I think they're going to try it again too.
Are they going to?
Get a hold of Red Bull. See if we could have the Flutog down here.
I'll have to get in touch with Red Bull. So just keep them coming. Everybody has my email address. Shoot me any ideas as they come to you. I'll check them at 3 a.m. Probably not.
Yeah.
Don't expect that response.
I can give you a report on Kerr Street and LP Willingham.
Okay.
Kerr Street is fine. They had a camping event overnight Friday night, and the kids seemed to have a good time. LP Willingham, the bowl fountain is underway. If you've been by lately, they've already taken up the concrete out in front of the train station. And I don't have a rendering, but I have a sketch of what it looks like, and it should be pretty nice, the fountain that they're putting in. That's about it.
Willingham, LP Willingham, it looked like they need to either extend that dock or whatever they've got down there, because it was about full of fishermen.
That's a good point. We're going to have to do something at least with the parking, because we don't encourage parking on the grass, but there's not enough parking spaces. It is in the budget to.
It's in the CIP to extend the dock out on the water there.
Yeah.
It's popular.
Do we think though that
well utilized.
The new boat front, like,
it might alleviate some of that traffic. It might be that the Jacksonville Landing will offset some of the traffic down there, but.
I don't know that it'll alleviate the type of traffic that's down at LP Willingham. They're more wanting to be on there and do the crabbing or whatever it is they're doing.
Right.
I don't know that the launching area of the landing resolves that, but obviously we'll see.
Yeah. You know when that's going to open?
It's moving right along.
September.
Sometime in September is.
It's pretty much on schedule too.
Yeah.
Yes, sure is.
It's moving right along.
Okay, with nothing else, next meeting is June 23rd, right here, 6 o'clock. So, looking for a motion to adjourn?
I'll move.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We stand adjourned.
How does this happen?